Here we have an ordinary North American outlet. What we're going to do in this video is replace this outlet with a GFCI outlet or a ground fault circuit interrupter. This is a little bit safer. Normally here in North America, these types of ground fault interrupters are installed in kitchens, bathrooms, garages, or outdoor outlets. The first thing I want to do here is measure the RMS voltage between hot and neutral. Hot's over here on the right, neutral's on the left. Nominally, this should be about 120 volts, and it's reading 123.8 volts. Let's measure between hot and ground. Of course, that's also nominally 120 volts. If I measure the voltage between neutral and ground, of course, it's zero. The reason for that is that hot and neutral are tied together at the breaker box. I have here a light bulb with two wires coming out of it. Black here is for hot and white's for neutral. Of course, the light bulb doesn't care which is which, but we're following the standard color code here. We wouldn't normally want to plug in a light bulb without a proper plug, but I'm doing it so that the connections are clear. We can see that the light bulb turns on properly if I connect black to hot and white to neutral. Of course, the light bulb doesn't turn on at all if I connect white to neutral and black to ground. But I want to show something interesting here. If I hook up white to ground and I hook up our hot to the black wire, the light bulb still turns on. And this is potentially an unsafe situation because what we have here is current coming out through the black wire, but it's not returning through the neutral wire. Normally, that would only happen if there's a fault somewhere in the circuit. For example, if someone's getting shocked, then their body might be making contact with the hot somewhere, and then the ground could be something other than this rather safe ground right here. For example, if somebody were touching the hot with one arm and then using the other arm to hold on to a copper water pipe, then the electricity would go through their body, they would get a shock, and the outlet here wouldn't know or it wouldn't care about it. And that's really the difference between this traditional outlet here and the GFCI outlet that we're about to install. Now, before we replace this outlet, we need to go down to the circuit breaker box and make sure we turn off the switch to this particular circuit. We have the switch turned off here for this outlet, but let's double check just to make sure the voltage between hot and neutral is indeed zero. What you'll notice here is that on the back side of the outlet, we actually have five wires coming into it. The bare wire here is just the earth ground. We have two whites and two blacks. The blacks are the hots and the whites are the neutral. But why do we have two of them? Why are the two sets here? Well, one black and one white are carrying power from the circuit breaker box into this outlet. One of the other sets, one black and one neutral, are branching off to give power to another outlet that's basically just in parallel with this one. In order to install the GFCI outlet, though, we need to know which set is carrying the power to the outlet and which set is carrying power away from the outlet. In other words, we need to know which one is the line and which one is the load. In order to do that, we're first going to take these wires out, and then we're going to have to turn the power back on at the circuit breaker box and see which one of these black wires is hot. We have 124 volts between neutral and hot on this side. On the right side, we have zero. Therefore, I can identify these as the load, and then these two are the line. Let's go turn the breaker off again now that we've identified which is line and which is load. Let's double check here just to make sure we actually got the power off. 0 volts. All right. Now that we have the outlet taken off, we can see on the back that we basically just have three different connections: ground, neutral, and hot. On the new outlet, we basically have five connections: earth, ground, line, and load. We already know that these two wires carry the power from the line, and these two wires here are the load. Here on the back of our GFCI outlet, the left side of line is labeled hot and the right side is labeled white or neutral. Theoretically, we could just hook both of the hot wires to this side, and then we could hook both of the neutral wires over here to the right. In that situation, only this particular outlet would benefit from the ground fault protection. But if we hook these two wires to line, and we hook these two wires up here to load, then it means that this outlet and any other outlets that are downstream of the load would also be protected by this one outlet. Let's go ahead and do that because that situation is just a little bit safer. All right, now that we have all of our connections made, we can go ahead and screw this outlet back into the wall and put on a new cover plate for it. So when I flipped the breaker, the red light came on. We just need to reset it to get it started. Now that we finished installing our outlet, let's go ahead and test it. If I hook white to neutral and black to hot, we can see that our light bulb works just like it ought to work. Let's now try to make the same fault condition that we created earlier by hooking up hot to black, but then let's pass current through the ground. The light bulb doesn't turn on and a breaker has tripped. Not only has this particular outlet tripped off, but all the other outlets attached in parallel with this outlet on the load side have also switched off. This is basically a small residual current device, which we've now reset. You could think of a GFCI outlet as a miniature circuit breaker that protects this outlet and all of the other outlets on the load side. We have a whole series of professionally filmed and edited videos in order to help students learn the fundamentals of electricity. If you like watching this particular video, then you might like to check out some of our others too.